One of the best accessibility features on the Microsoft Edge browser is the Read Aloud feature. As the name suggests, it reads text on web pages for you. There's also the Immersive Reader, which can help make articles easier to read. Hi everyone, this is Carrie on Accessibility, where we talk about technology and accessibility. If you're interested in that type of content, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell so you can be updated on all the latest videos. As I mentioned earlier, this video is going to go over the Read Aloud and Immersive Reader. However, this is part of a new series that I'll be doing that are throwbacks from an older channel. A lot of the information is still really relevant, and it also helps me to save time so I can make other and new videos. I'm also working on archiving the older channel, so this is part of it. One thing to note is that I was using equipment that is not as good as what I have now, so hopefully you can still have some patience with it. Without further ado, let's move on. The first feature is Read Aloud, and yes, it reads a page aloud to you, whether you're in the Immersive Reader mode or if you're just in the regular web browser mode. And the Immersive Reader works with mostly blogs and articles, and it strips away advertisements and other sidebars, your navigation, links and everything like that, and it just has the main content of that page. And from there, you can change the font size and the different color, the background, different text colors. It also has some other tools as well. So let's transition over to my computer and I can show you guys how these two features work. So here I have Microsoft Edge and I have the Live Accessible page open to one of our blogs. And here, if I wanted it to read aloud for me, I can press Control Shift U.
New Android TalkBack update. 2020 multi-finger gestures. October 20th, 2020 by Carrie.S.Morales.
Press Control Shift U again. Read Aloud highlights the word that it's currently reading in yellow and the line that it's reading in blue. And if you press Control Shift U again and it starts again, you can click anywhere on the screen and on any word, any part of the article, and it'll start reading from there. But it only works while it's reading.
Release of Android Accessibility Suite 8.2 and TalkBack 9. How to enable TalkBack multi-finger gestures. Test updates. In order to proceed with enabling multi...
The only thing, sometimes, if you click in the middle of a word, it'll start right in the middle, so it won't actually tell you what that word is. It'll only verbalize the letters of where you clicked. If you do want it to read starting from a specific line, I suggest while it's reading, click slightly to the left of that line and it'll start reading from there. When you have Read Aloud active, it puts a toolbar near the top of your browser, and at the top there is a play button.
Multi-finger gesture.
And there is the previous sentence and next sentence. Previous and next sentences only work when it's playing, and unfortunately they don't have a keyboard shortcut for going back and forth, which I really wish they had. I have contacted them and asked for that feature, and hopefully they will do that in the future. If you go over to the right, you're going to see another button that says voice options. And if you click there, you can change the speed and the voice. So here is probably the default voice that it would be if you guys used it. So I'm gonna play it.
Gestures. Your device must have the following. Android 11. Android Accessibility Suite 8.2 or later.
So that will probably be the default voice you have, so you can go to the settings and change that. If you do try this feature out, you'll probably see that I have a lot more voices here than what's available, because I believe there's only 3 that's available. So if you want to get more voices, right under that, there's a link that says, learn how to add more voices. So you can click there and I'll walk you through how to add more voices. Another thing you can do is select a word where you want to start and then press Control Shift U and it'll start
playing. How to enable TalkBack multi-finger gestures.
If you want to exit out of Read Aloud, you can go to the toolbar and press the X button, or you can also press just the escape button on your keyboard. If you're a screen reader user, you can navigate to that toolbar if you press F6. Right now I'm running JAWS, so for me it's F6.
F6, leaving menu bar, new Android TalkBack updates when F6, tab bar tab.
Keep pressing F6.
F6, favorites bar tool F6, toolbar, continue the read aloud button to activate.
And right there, once it says read aloud, toolbar, you just press tab.
Voice options button to activate, press space, close button to activate, continue the read aloud button to activate,
press and space again, bar. The previous paragraph and the next paragraph is not enabled unless the read aloud is currently reading. So if it is reading,
update 2020 multi-finger gestures,
you'll be able to go next and previous. And you just press tab and shift tab to navigate through the toolbar and press space to activate a button. The other accessibility feature is Immersive Reader, and to enable this, you press the F9 button. And unfortunately, this only works for blogs and articles and just certain pages where this feature is available. To get out of the Immersive Reader, you just have to press F9 again, and sometimes it takes a couple of seconds for the original page to load. And when you do have Immersive Reader on, it takes away all the advertisements and excessive links and the sidebars and anything that isn't the main content on the page. This is really helpful if you want to focus on what the article or the blog is saying, and it's also great when you are using a screen reader since you don't have to go through all the advertisement and it's easier to find the actual content. The Immersive Reader has its own toolbar at the top for the browser right under the address bar, and here you can also do read aloud and you can use the control shift U if you want, and it also has the text preferences. So if you click there, you can make it bigger or smaller and you can change the text spacing. If I do find that if you do turn that on, it's really spaced out, so I prefer just the regular spacing. And then right under that, there's different page themes. So my favorite is white on black, but you can choose any other theme, or you can click down here where it says more themes, and then you have a lot of other themes and colors that you can change this page to. An update they made to text preferences is now you can choose your font family. You can choose Calibri, Sitka, or Comic Sans, and you can also adjust your column style so there'll be more or less space on the left and right. There also used to be a grammar toolbar that would label nouns, adjectives, different parts of speech, but it looks like they may have removed that. And the next one is reading preferences. The first one is line focus. So if you turn that on, it'll give you just a few lines to focus on, and it will make the other parts of the page that you're not looking at shadowed. So you can only clearly see just a couple lines, and you can control this. You can only have one line at a time, or you can have multiple lines like this. There used to be an option called picture dictionary, which would show these little pictures to help you understand what's written, but it looks like it's no longer on the menu. The next one is translating. Here you can change the language of the whole article, and they have quite a few languages to choose from, and you can choose to translate the entire page. And if you're using JAWS or another screen reader, you can press Alt-Shift-R to go to the Immersive Reader tools.
Alt-Shift-R, toolbar, read aloud button to activate, press spacebar.
From there, you can press Tab to go through the different buttons.
Text preferences button to activate, press spacebar.
And you press space to
space, text
activate
side, left, right,
that
slider,
button.
182% 5.
And then you can press Tab to go through the different options.
Text spacing checkbox not checked. Page themes, dark theme radio button checked, 4 or 5.
I do want to mention that the text size option is not accessible
text
with
space,
JAWS.
Text size left, right, slider, 100.
I've tried everything, and unfortunately, it does not work. However, if you're using Narrator and
text
you go to
dialogue,
text preferences,
text size, slider at 1,
and you go to the text size, you can press the left and right arrow
182%
keys.
182%, 300, 100.
And increase and decrease the text size. So I'm not sure what's wrong with accessibility when it comes to JAWS, but it does work with Narrator. And it also works with NVDA. So that is how to use Read Aloud and the Immersive Reader on Microsoft Edge. I really like using this so that I can listen to articles and web pages, whatever I need to listen to while I'm doing something else, because I'm always multitasking and working on a lot of things, and I still want to keep updated, especially when it comes to accessibility and technology. So this is one way I try to save some time, and it's just a lot easier on my eyes because a lot of reading causes me eye strain. I also do use a screen reader sometimes, but I really like the fact that I don't really have to do much. I don't have to press down. I don't have to skip over advertisements or graphics and things like that. I can just press one keyboard shortcut, Control-Shift-U, and have it read everything for me. Since I use Windows Magnifier, I could also use the reader that's built into it, but it's kind of finicky and it has some issues and it doesn't always read everything. And again, I can't play it in the background. If you're not sure about the reader on the Windows Magnifier, I will be doing a throwback video for that as well, because I did do a video on that. If that's already out, I will post that in the YouTube card over there or down in the description. That's it for now. Let me know if you have any feedback on this throwback segment. And remember that pink is better than green. Thanks so much, everybody. I'll catch you in the next one.